One thing we're at the end of last segment, we were talking about the best kind of greeting, a bro hug, a handshake. Yeah. Fist bump is number one in my book because it's germ free.
Yep.
You can initiate it by just walking up to somebody with a fist and they know exactly what to do. There's no handshake versus hug controversy. And it's better than a handshake, but it's not quite a hug. It's perfect.
I know. The one problem, though, is if someone goes for the high five and another person goes for the fist bump.
Oh, the gobbler?
Yeah, that's always a rough one.
Yeah, the gobbler, because your fist against a flat hand looks like a turkey.
Yep.
Yeah, no, that's terrible.
Also, how high up the corporate chain can a fist bump go? Like, you're meeting the president of our company. Can you go fist bump?
I don't know. We're sort of an entertainment company, so I think the formality...
sort of. I hope we are. I mean, if not, what are we doing?
I'm not meeting the head of the White & Case law firm. Yeah, I think this is loose enough that you...
Back
you
your paralegal days?
No,
you
but actually, the CEO, you have to do an old school handshake, right? Which is...
You got to follow their lead. Maybe they're fist bumping, then maybe you can.
How about you as a woman? Would you hug him?
No, I would have... I put out the hand for a solid Bill Belichick handshake.
Interesting. What if they went in for the hug? Then you got to hug.
Yeah, I mean, you got to hug them. Man or woman, right? I mean, you don't have to do anything, but that gets into a whole other issue. But no. I think that generally a handshake with the boss is the way to go.
I think you're right, but
I don't generally get in the habit of hugging people at work anyway.
Do you give Spike handshakes? Spike's not a handshake guy, it doesn't seem like. He's more of a fist bump guy.
Why, because he's young?
That's just his general demeanor.
No, he's a bit of a not fan of germs, as I recall.
I would not go in for a hug, that's for sure. I think a fist bump.
Spike's a fist bump guy. I've seen it. I think a lot of people are fist bump guys. Because post-COVID, you know, the handshake, if you think about it, if you really think about it.
Let's not really think about
it. It's super gross.
Yeah, I don't want to think about, you know, where people's hands have been. That's the last thing I want to think about.
Do you ever go, and this happens a lot when we're at conventions or Super Bowl, you shake 100 hands.
Yes.
Are you ever more desperate to wash your hands in that moment?
Absolutely not. And that's when you got to have the microbial gel or whatever.
Yeah.
It's funny. Antifungal.
Bro hug is, in a way, less intimate than a handshake. You're not as exchanging.
But your faces are getting closer.
More intimate, maybe less.
Wait. What kind of bro hug are your faces getting close? You gotta keep the heads to the side in an appropriate bro.
Yeah, but it's still getting closer than if your arms stretched out.
Yeah.
Yes, but that skin-to-skin contact of the hand-to-hand is pretty, I mean, that's basically second base in my book.
Jeffrey Howell in our chat has the perfect solution.
What's that?
Just give the CEO a wedgie. Power move.
Yeah. They will not forget you, that's for sure, when they're escorting you out of the building.
Touch the CEO's underwear? What is going on here?
Yeah. We might be embarking on a little bit of a turf war here with the Weedos in the chat.
Wait, what do the Weedos want to do?
No, well, they're all upset about this. Well, CBS Sports Radio, whoever handles the chat
on
the CBS Sports Radio page, is very upset about the word that starts with M that everyone seems to use. It's an M word that refers to pork or wet things or damp things.
Oh.
Yeah. And so there's everybody in the chat.
Why are we tiptoeing around it like it's a curse word?
Can't say it personally.
I'll say it. Ugh. I don't want to now because you just set it up this way. Ugh. Moist?
What
did I do? I didn't do anything.
You know what you did, Maggie.
I didn't do anything.
You said it and you had a smile from ear to ear.
I did not enjoy that. Wait a minute. I think this is overblown. It's just a word.
It's so gross. Like the sound
you're talking
of
about
it, what it means, every part of it.
You made it seem like we were going to get fined by the FCC if I said it.
It's
not one of those words.
They should. Give us the F word back and take away the M word.
I can't even say the general manager of the Green Bay Packers last name. It'll be fine. that dude's a minefield.
Dangerous one. Yeah.
Now I can't say it.
Goody's good.
Don't do it.
Yeah, just Goody. Go Goody.
Yeah.
Goody.
Oh, boy.
Anyway, everyone in the chat now.
There's M word. Pork was one of the chat names, and somebody, whoever is running the CBS Sports Radio account, clearly doesn't like that word, as most of us don't, made a comment, and now everybody in the Weedos chat is changing their name to M-Word and then their name. So we have M-Word RPC, we have M-Word Gerard, we have M-Word Craig. It's just not going well.
It's going to turn into the CBS Sports Radio versus the Weedos.
Yeah.
And that's not what we aim to be around here. But that's where it's going.
We just want a community without that word in it.
You know who would hate a moist handshake more than anything in the world?
Oh, come on.
Ackerman.
How do I know that? I walked right into that.
You walked in the room, I'm like, oh. Talking about a man who's uncomfortable with intimacy. Let alone germ passing around.
But a moist, doesn't want to be in the studio with
it. But a moist handshake, that's just...
It's the worst.
No, it's a bad feeling, you know? It's
like, you got to either rub your hand on your pants or
exactly.
something. You got to get rid of that moisture. And especially if you're meeting someone like the boss... You got to make sure hands are dry. Got to keep it cool.
It's weird. Moisture I'm actually okay with. It's just you take away the part.
Very specific.
It's very weird.
I hear you. What about, okay.
Do some people sweat on their hands, though? That's got to stink.
I think there is a condition like
yeah,
that, though.
I'm sure. There's a condition for everything.
I feel bad for those people.
I forgot one more kiss scenario. What about people who don't want to kiss on the cheek, want to kiss lip to lip?
Ugh, who's doing that?
Like relatives.
Who's doing that?
That happens all the time. That is out there. You guys have never run into this?
No.
No.
You've never met a lip-to-lip kisser. They exist. You guys are looking at me like I made this up.
A lip-to-lip kisser.
Yeah, they exist.
Who you're not married to or
like
your,
Oh, an aunt may be a little bit different.
Yeah, I know.
I've done the accidental lip kiss where you both go to the same side and you try to do the cheek.
I'm embarrassed for you just hearing about that.
Yeah. No.
You haven't done that? Everybody's done that. You go to the same side accidentally and then you just, whoops.
No, there are lip-to-lip kissers out there.
There are.
Not with strangers. Not just meet someone.
No.
That's insanity. That's assault.
Often family or friends.
No, I don't have one of those people in my life. Thank God.
The lip-to-lip kissers, with their kids, I also find to be a little bit off.
Yeah, it, depends on the age,
Yeah.
Because,
a toddler's a little bit different.
Yeah.
But, a seven-year-old.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, I know. Now we're getting to Tom Brady territory, aren't we? I know this is, all roads are going to lead to Brady.
Oh, I forgot about that.
Yeah,
it's not something I think about all the time.
I mean, I don't either, but, they're obviously in the news a little bit this week. 855-212-4CBS. I don't actually want anyone to call about this. I don't know. I'm sorry. I have no advice for you. This would be good for the advice duck, but I have no advice for you on a lip-to-lip kisser in your life. I'm so lucky I don't have one.
Just in case people are listening, let's move on because I don't want to make anyone feel bad. I don't care. I actually don't mind. I don't care. I'd rather do a lip-to-lip kiss than a moist handshake. On the power rankings of bad things.
Oh, that's not right. No, a moist handshake at least. Well, let's do.
Well that's like a double overtime advancing, though.
Oh, yeah, we have our bracket at the worst.
We did put a moist handshake on there. We should have put it on. Our top five things that the worst, what are we calling these, social encounters?
Yeah, greetings. Greetings is a specific territory. I guess goodbye is a little bit, too.
I'll come up with something. Moist handshake and lip-to-lip kiss are definitely on there. I just don't know in what order.
Yeah. Do we put on the gobbler when one person goes for fist bump, the other goes for a high five?
Definitely. This thing is going to be
easy. High five. High five's kind of awesome, by the way.
Gobbler?
The gobbler.
Yeah.
Never heard that. I know the motion.
Yeah.
I've done it many, many times. But I've never heard the word. That's awesome. Gobbler. Okay.
How about the old school high five? It's 1983. Why not? Let's do it.
It's back.
Oh, is it back?
Oh, yeah.
High five.
High five. I'll high five you like this.
Yeah, what about the Tom Cruise Top Gun high five where you go up top, then come around?
That was never not cool.
How about a David Putty?
What does Putty do from Seinfeld?
He would just go, high five.
To Elaine, though, to his girlfriend.
Like after coitus.
Yeah.
Oh, first we have moist, and now we have...
Post-coital high five.
Coitus. That is also a word that nobody wants to hear on the radio.
Meanwhile, Samter's fine with that one, but bring moist around, and all of a sudden he's running for the hills.
Coitus is fine. Moist coitus, no thank you.
Some words are even worse when you make them. The clinical word is even worse than the normal word, and that is one of them.
You want less, not more.
Wow, that was wonderful coitus, honey.
High five.
High five.
Bro, hug it, baby.
I really hope my mom was watching that one. 855-212-4CBS, 855-212-4227. I blame it, Ackerman. I don't know why. Coming up, we never got to John Morant. We'll do that. Sorry, Ack.